Excuse me. He could have told me to wipe the breakfast off my face. I love this magazine. I didn't like the last one, though. So now that I got two, I guess I'll pay for it. This is awesome. In this issue, we were talking about a lot of different things. I like this magazine. It doesn't just do one thing. It talks about a lot of different things. Which is okay, as long as it doesn't have none of that seed bead stuff, I'm good. Blacksmithing. And there's an article here I wanted to share with you guys, because you can't just get everything off. Well, you probably can. Everything online. Come on. Where's my article? Why didn't I see what page it was on? Fudge. Okay, so now there's some pearls out there. It's like $165 for one pearl, okay? Dang it, where is it? And you're so fascinating, because I didn't know about South Sea pearls, okay? Here, we'll do it this way. Yeah. So this author is saying, Sharon Elaine Thompson, Smoking Stones. Beware that the smaller pearls sold as baby South Sea pearls are probably freshwater pearls and not true South Sea pearls. I'd be pissed. Okay, to the millions of everybody, how much cost? Single round white pearls from $260 and up. A single round yellow golden pearls from $165 and up. Strands from $1,000 and up. How hard are these? Size 9 to 20 millimeters are readily available online. Yada, yada, yada. Okay, forget all that. Yeah, so you remember me and my howlite turquoise? Yeah. Gotta be careful what you buy. And that's why you just buy from reputable people on Etsy or Cesarca. You know, people who go dig up the stuff out the dirt themselves. Yeah, trust them. Not all lapidaries do. They call themselves a lapidary, but they don't go dig up the stuff themselves. This is just absolutely fascinating to me, because, you know, like I just said, I've been burned once. It wasn't fun. Excuse me. But this magazine is really, really good. A lot of metalsmithing stuff. Operator? This is just really, really amazing to me. Gee whiz. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't necessarily want to pay full price for everything, but I'm still going to tell you the truth. The ear wires are not sterling, but everything else is. I mean, I don't know, I just don't get liars, why you have to do that, just to make more money. Money is not the end all be all. Look at this. Okay, this is one project I would really love to do once I figure it out. Is that not beautiful? Is that not beautiful? Okay, and it teaches how to make this pendant. Excuse me. Isn't that gorgeous? I love this magazine. Also, I have some magazines that have the seed bead stuff in it, and I don't like that. So email me if you want it. Send me a dollar for postage. TashaSpeaks@gmail.com. So beautiful. Wow. I don't want to get probably too deep into blacksmithing, but a little bit. You know, I mean, I'd love to learn how to make that. Some other little stuff in here. But anyway, the purpose of this is, you know, be careful. Read. Pay attention. Be, you know, broad-minded. be broad-minded from everything you buy to everything you read, you know? Don't sink yourself into one, being so focused on one thing, especially you newbies, and say, oh, I only want to do this. Mm-hmm. Next month you're going to be like, oh, I want to do that. And then the clay, and then the metal, and then the... Stay flexible all the time. All the time. So then that way when somebody gives you, you know, a nice set of dapping cube and punch set, this is what I think I'm going to get, a small set of. For making things... But it's used for a lot of different things, right? Other than just, okay, because you see the little cube right here, right? So you know it's automatically going to be for something to force into that shape. But from that shape, you can do countless other things. See, it's not just you buy one thing for that one purpose. I mean, you could only afford needle-nose pliers and, you know, nippers. But you can use those needle-nose pliers for lots of things. You use the back, the middle, the front. You know, you use the whole tool until you can get the tool that project actually calls for. You know what I mean? You don't just say, oh, I can't make ear hooks. I don't have anything round to make the hook form against. Well, you go get a pencil. Go get a pen. Form your ear hook around that. This is so beautiful. Wow. Now he's giving us lessons on our gems. When not to heat. Yeah, because you got to go against, you know, the Mohs, M-O-H-S scale, Mohs scale of hardness, and see what kind of stuff you can heat, how hot, and all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. This is so beautiful. Wow. I really learned a lot from this magazine. See, and this is what I want. This is really what I want to get into. I really got to get good at soldering and get over my dislike of fire. This. You see it? It's got the flat plate on the bottom. And then you take your ring, which you've already measured around your cabochon or stone. And then you really can't see. I should have used the other camera today. The little bits of soldering. So when you solder it, it stays together, hopefully. One not so good experience, but it's okay, it's a learning lesson. Absolutely fascinating. I can't wait to do this. Anyway, this isn't my style, but I know a lady that would like a necklace like this. Let me teach you how to do this one. You know, they teach you in this one how to use your stamps, letters, designs, whatever. I would like to have one with my own logo to stamp into my jewelry tags, which I'm going to start buying. Introducing a new 3-in-1 concave cutter. Oh, I see. I thought it was a deburring cup. It's a cutter to round, oh, well, it's like a deep burring cup. Burring. You know what I mean. See? That's fascinating. That is really fascinating. Anyway, this is a really good, I like this one. I like this one. And, oh, where's the agate thing? Come on, hurry fast. Montana Moss Agate. So beautiful. So many good lessons in here. So many good lessons. So let's not get bogged down with just one thing. I'm not saying do a lot of projects at once. I'm saying focus on one thing at a time. But when you shop or have ideas, it might behoove you to say, oh, well, that's only 2 cents. Why don't I get 10 of those things at 2 cents? I'll figure out what it does later. And sure enough, you always figure out what it does later, and then you implement it, and then you get addicted to that for a little while, like me and bead caps. And those little horn things that go at the end of necklaces when you tie it. I'm really into those now. Anyway, yeah, just stay open-minded. Stay open-minded. You know, and look around your house. They're the simplest things you could use. You know, even you could use a safety pin. Well, save it, because if you happen to start out on plastic beads, you're going to need something to get the plastic out of the middle of plastic beads. Yeah. See, even a safety pin comes in handy. Every little thing, almost, around your house can come in handy for jewelry making. Trust me. Because until you can afford to buy it, you need to use something, right? And people say, oh, I have to have this. No, you don't. You need to substitute that until you can comfortably afford it. So use a pen instead of this, or, you know, whatever. Operator? Hello? Thank you. Let's all stay open-minded, you know? When I had a profit, I'd buy some clay. Oh, I still have bronze clay, by the way. I don't like it. So if you want it, write to me. You need to send postage, though. I just can't be giving away everything all the time. I bought some copper metal clay. I have not taken the time to learn properly how to get the timing right for firing. I made like 10 things. They all broke. So, yeah, I'll study that. I was open-minded. I bought a little of everything because, you know, I had a sale, made my profit, and I, you know, bought that. And I still use that for my polymer, all the stuff that I got, I still use for my polymer clay, which I love now. See, I was not open-minded. I was not open to that. And then somebody gave me some, and I'm like, oh. And I made a little piece of cake, remember? It was really cute. Anyway, I'm going to be working with that more. And that's another thing I want to get into. I need a pasta machine. Put the clay in, comes out flat on the other side. It makes it pliable. Yeah, anyway. I'm going to get into that more and more and more and more. And then I'll be mixing it. Now that I have found patterns that I don't have to keep a whole bunch of clay around. I don't want to store clay. I'm not into the canes. The cane is when you make a long, round, or square, whatever, pattern of clay, and you cut a piece and cut a piece and cut a piece and cut a piece, so you still have this much of it left. And they store those in the rubber bins. I'm not storing stuff. I want to make a set and get rid of the rest of the clay. that sounds probably kind of contradictory. But yeah, I stay open-minded to the fact that I want to do that, but I also stay open-minded to the fact that I can donate the rest to somebody else. I'm getting older. I'm not into storing stuff anymore. So yeah, that's going to be a neat new experience for me to get more and more and more into my metalsmithing and my polymer. And then now people are starting to ask me, oh, would you, you know, clean this, clean that? Ladies, get a polishing cloth. First of all, you know how we set our jewelry out so we can see it and it looks all pretty? Yeah, tarnish. Polishing cloth. You could pay me to do it. I'm going to charge you $50. Yeah, because those little tiny things are so intricate and stuff. Man, that's a lot of work. Yeah. So I buy a really good something like that. Polishing cloth for like $6, because they're normally like $1. But that one came highly recommended from WWJ Group. And I love it. I love it. The lady was happy to pay the $50, and I was happy to buy that $6 cloth, because what a profit I made, huh? For just sitting here polishing cloth while I'm at work. It was great. Anyway, yeah, so let's all stay open-minded to things we don't know about yet, you know? And I'm telling you, thrift stores are the best places to go buy stuff from. They are. They are. Anywho, I'm going to stay open-minded. You stay open-minded and varied. And let's keep on learning together. What did you recently learn? Okay, put it down there in the comments. Okay. Go have a good day. Email me if you want the magazine or the clay. TashaSpeaks@gmail.com. You know, you could throw down a couple of dollars for postage. Okay, love yourself. Go have a great day. Bye. Beautiful necklace, huh? I think I paid $5 for it in my Avon. Now, you know what I see when I see things like this? Lots of bathroom earrings. I do. So, newbies, just find a starting point and get going. I try to leave the little thingamajigger on intact as much as possible. Operator. Thank you. So when you take it off, you don't have any extra work to do by putting another one on. You just take it off. That's it, see? That's one earring. That's it. And do I have one? No, I don't have one ready, sorry. If you had the eye pin, again, I should have brought the other camera. This is a head pin. Morning.
Morning.
See that it's flat on that side? That's a head pin. Eye pin is the one with the hole, the circle down here. And then you just put that on, make a loop, and that's it. Earring and ear hook in one. Anyway, so I'm gonna get my eye hooks out now and just make that an earring. See, and then the ladies here, when they forget their earrings or whatever, and they come for business meetings, they just go to the bathroom, buy more earrings. So I'm gonna finish that up, finish up some others. Yeah, see, look at that. Each one of these is gonna be an earring. I'm thinking about making a bracelet too, because I think Doc, oh, don't tell Doc, that, say hi, Doc.
Hi, Doc.
Yeah, see all those earrings, chain to use for something else. That's probably, it's not 7 inches. But it doesn't matter. Keep the chain, make a bracelet. There you go. See, so that's like 100 different pairs of earrings right there. Or a bracelet or whatever. You could take the whole pin out and just have the thing with the hole in it, the bead with the hole in it, and make a necklace or something. But see these little tiny pearls and little tiny crystals right here on the end. It's going to be like bathroom earrings. Sometimes I'll put the larger ones in too, but most of the ladies come here. Like the small ones for working. Okay.